Okay, so this is going to be the first video in this series covering the EV conversion of my 96 Nissan Hardbody 4x4 pickup truck. So a few years ago, the motor went out and I decided not to rebuild it this year when I actually got to this project and decided that I was going to do an EV swap. Utilizing Nissan Leaf components to make this an EV that gets more power, more torque, and a decent range while still allowing for me to keep it 4x4 capable for off-roading and just daily use. So I just have a better understanding of electronic components than I do with gas components. So I figured it'd be easier just to pull the motor out instead of rebuilding it, sell it to somebody that needs it. And I'll use a drivetrain that I'm more comfortable with, which is electric. So the first thing that I want to cover is the motor that I will be utilizing. It's an EM57 motor from a Nissan Leaf. It was used in a variety of other applications. And it's got multiple subcomponents within it that allow it to do its job. So the first component is going to be the power distribution module, which is right here. That's going to do a lot of the high voltage routing and whatnot. So it's going to do things like switch your 400 volt battery pack voltage down to 12 volts that the rest of the car components can use, as well as charging and a few other things like that. The second layer of the Nissan Leaf stack is going to be the inverter. This is going to change DC power of the battery into AC and vice versa when regenerative braking occurs. And then the final component from here down is going to be the actual motor itself. And I've already got the adapter plate attached as well as the coupler. This adapter was built by Brat Industries, I believe out of Canada. And it allows me to bolt this motor directly to the transmission of the hard body. It will be clutchless, so I will mount the motor stack right here where the motor used to be, and it'll bolt directly to the transmission, and that will move the drivetrain. Everything else down the line, the transmission, transfer case, drive shafts, all that stuff will operate as they used to, with little to no modification. I also had the transmission and transfer case rebuilt before I started this project. I will keep the shifter inside. How I will utilize that will depend on how it operates after the conversion, but for the most part, I think I'll just keep it in about second gear. Wouldn't have to switch for much. So let's see here, what's next on the list? This is kind of a deviation from the drivetrain, but because we lose the power steering pump, I decided to opt for what is done, a swap that's usually done in kind of older retro muscle cars, is put an electronic power steering column in. And this steering column actually has, let me go around to the other side, an electric motor on the steering column right here. And this is going to, essentially the steering column detects the torque being input by the user and amplifies that torque coming through to the output shaft, which will, when I've completed it, adapt together and go to the power steering box, which I have looped the lines, and this will allow it to operate kind of as a manual box while keeping the original power steering ratio that the automatic power steering box provides. So let's see. Another thing that's on the motor stack will be the AC compressor. I'm hoping I can control this via Linbus. I think there's some code out there that people have contributed that'll allow me to activate it. That will connect to this component, which is the next part of this drivetrain from the Leaf. So this is going to be a regular radiator, the AC condenser, and then the fans, as well as the water pump that circulates the coolant through the inverter and through the motor. And there's little waste heat created by these devices, but there is still a little bit, just enough that it requires cooling. But it doesn't create enough heat like a ICE car that I'm able to heat the vehicle without, or with the coolant. So what I'm going to need to do is get the heating element out of the Nissan Leaf. And I haven't gotten that out yet, but it essentially works like a space heater, super high powered space heater that I'll have to retrofit into this box and make it heat the cabin. But I'm gonna try and adapt this AC compressor to the AC system in the truck with as many newer components as I can. And we'll see where it goes from there. Let's see here. So the next thing in the drivetrain that I pulled from the Nissan Leaf is going to be the 24 kilowatt hour battery pack. Now this battery pack is from a salvaged Nissan Leaf. It's degraded to the point where it gets about 35 miles on a charge. Not really usable, but I've just placed it in the bed to use it as a test battery. And I will use it to get the drivetrain as running as a proof of concept, and then I will build a battery pack. And then the battery pack, the goal is to get a battery pack that'll get me about 150 to 200 miles on a charge. I think that's gonna get me around Arizona where I need to, as well as getting me out in the trail in a way that I won't have any range anxiety out there. I do plan on putting a solar panel on the bed that will allow me to charge the vehicle while I'm camping, among just, you know, charging for free while it's sitting idle in a parking spot. Let's see, what else do we got to cover? So the way I'm going to control the battery, the motor, and several of the other components is going to be through this spaghetti of wires here. This is the vehicle control unit. It's kind of an open inverter project, or EVBMW, I believe it is. It's an open source hardware and software vehicle control module for electric vehicle components. It can run not only the Nissan Leaf stack, but Tesla motors and a wide variety of other electric motors and devices like heaters, AC compressors, stuff like that. That's a video for another time. It goes super in depth, but let's see here. Overall, I think I've covered everything that we want to get in this video. I do plan on keeping the vehicle looking as stock as possible. The vehicle, kind of hard to see it with the lighting right now, but the vehicle squatting in the back, that's mostly because of the 600 pound battery pack in the back, but also because there's no motor in the front yet. I do plan on redoing the entire suspension. There's a broken leaf spring on the back wheel here, so I have to replace all the leaf springs, and I'm thinking I'm going to do a 3-inch lift with a 1,000-pound helper spring that will help kind of compensate for the 600-pound battery pack that I have now, but also probably the 1,000 pounds that the new battery pack will weigh. I plan on keeping the 31-inch tires to minimize rolling resistance and kind of keep it as efficient as possible while keeping it as 4x4 capable as well. Dash was in really sad condition, so that's going to be another project for another time, unless somebody knows where I can get an uncracked round dash for an hard body. And how everything will be controlled should mostly stay conventional, but we'll kind of see when we get there. But yeah, if you guys have any questions, comments, about the project, let me know in the comments, and I'll try and make a video explaining it. Have a good day.